वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज राहुल गर्ग, योर मैथ्स टीचर, एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर नंबर 5, दैट इज अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन. एंड दिस इज फिफ्थ पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. एंड स्टूडेंट, टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस द फॉर्मूला दैट इज द nth टर्म इक्वल्स a प्लस n माइनस 1 इंटू डी, वेयर a n means the nth term and a is the first term and n is number of terms, d is common difference, that we have already discussed in our previous classes. And today we will continue our exercise 5.2. we have covered first 11 question of this exercise and this is 12th question of your exercise 5.2. This is 12th question of your exercise 5.2. The question is, two APs have the same common difference. Two APs have the same common difference means D is same for both the APs and the difference between their 100th term is 100. What is the difference between their 1000th term? So now to differentiate two terms, we assume that the first term as a1, a2, a3. This we will use for first AP, and for the second AP we will use a dash, a dash 2, a dash 3. Now we have given that both the APs have same common difference, so D will be the same. Now the difference between the 100 term, if first term of first AP, let first term of first AP, first term of first AP be A dash, and let first term of second AP, we have given two APs, so for second AP assume A dash, or for first you will assume A. Now 100th term of first AP, that is A100, will be A plus 100 minus 1 into D, that is A plus 99D. This is the 100th term of first AP. Now the 100th term for second AP will be A dash plus 100 minus 1 into D, because common difference is given same. So I am using here D, not D, D dash. Now this is A plus, means A dash plus 100 minus 1, 99 into D. This is the 100th term of second AP. Now in the statement we have given that the difference between their 100th term is 100. So right here the difference, that is A100 minus A dash 100, means the 100th difference between their 100 term, that is 100. Now substitute A100 is A plus 99D minus A dash 100, that is A dash plus 99D equals 100. Now you know that this can be solved by using board mass. So first of all solve the bracket, that is A plus 99D minus A dash minus plus minus 99D equals 100. Now this 99D will be cancelled out with this minus 99D. So we left with A minus A dash equals 100. We found that A minus A dash is 100. In the statement, we are asked what is the difference between the 1000th term. Now, for 1000th term, A thousand minus A dash thousand. So this will be equals to A plus, apply the formula of nth term, A plus thousand, that is N minus 1 into D, minus A dash plus N, that is thousand minus 1 into D. A plus A dash plus 1000 minus 1 into D. So this is A plus 999D minus A dash minus plus minus plus 999 into D. This will become minus 999D. Now this get cancelled out. This will cancel out with this one and we left with A minus A dash. From this A minus A dash is 100. So answer will be 100. Student, first let the first term of first AP A and the second term for first term, for second AP will be A dash. Now apply the formula of nth term and solve and find A minus A dash. Then find the difference between the 1000 term. Now this is very important from your MCQ point of MCQ question point of view, because in MCQ question you will simply, if the two APs have the same common difference, then the difference between their respective term, means if here the term is asking that what is the difference between 500th term, then the answer will also be 100, because if the common difference is same, the difference will also be same. So this will be 100 for 1000 term, for 10,000 term, the answer will be same. Now the second 13th question is, how many 3 digit numbers are divisible? Okay, now let's discuss the 13th sum of the exercise 5.2. How many 3 digit numbers are divisible by 7? So first of all, we have to find the 3 digit number that are divisible by 7. Then we will find how many 3 digit numbers that are divisible by 7. So 3 digit numbers start from 100. Second 3 digit number is 101, 102, and so on. The last 3 digit number is 999. Now this is a 3 digit number. This is a series of 3 digit number, but we have to find the series that AP that is divisible by 7. So first 3 digit number that is divisible by 7 is 105, and the second 3 digit number that is divisible by 7 is 112, and the last 3 digit number that is divisible by 7 is 994. So this is my AP, which AP of divisible number by 7. Now A is, here A is 105, and my D, the common difference is 7, that is 112 minus 105, that is A2 minus A1, this will be 7. So common difference. Now we have to find N, number of terms. So nth term equals A plus N minus 1 into D. So nth term, that is the last term, is 994, and A, the first term is 105 plus N minus 1 into D, that is 7. You can solve this solve this equation and find the value of n. To solve, first take this 105 on the left hand side, and this is positive. When it goes goes in the left hand side, this will become negative. So 994 minus 105 equals n minus 1 into 7. So this will be 896. This will become 9889. So this is 889 equals n minus 1 into 7. Now divide this. Now to solve, take this 7. This is in the multiply. When it goes in the left hand side, this will goes in the denominator, and this will be n minus 1. So this is n minus 1, and n will be, first of all solve this, this will be 1 and then 2 and 7. So n will be 128. So there are 128 terms, 128 three digit number that are divisible by 7. Our next question is, how many multiples of 4 lie between 10 and 250? So first number lying between 10 and 250, that is multiple of 4, means that is divisible by 4, is 12. The second will be add 4, that is 16, and so on. The third, last number will be 248. Now this is again the similar question of we have done in 13th question. We have to find n, where first term is given, and we will find d, which is 4, and the nth term, that is 248. The next question is the 15th question. For what value of n are the nth term of 2ap? Means here we have given 2 APs. First AP is this and the second AP is this. We have to find the value of n for which these 2 APs have equal nth term. So first, in the first AP, that is in 63, 65, 67, my A is 63 and D, common difference will be find from by using the formula A2 minus A1. That is 2. Now nth term will be A plus n minus 1 into D. So A is 63 plus n minus 1 into D is 2. Now for the second AP, that is 3, 10, 17. My A is 3. And D will be 10 minus 3, that is 7, by using the formula A2 minus A1. Now nth term, because we are finding the nth term, that is equal. So in this nth term will be A plus n minus 1 into D, that is 7. Now we have given that the nth term of both the AP is equal. So put equal, both the APs, nth term of both the APs put equal. Now this is my first and this is for second AP. Now solve. First take these 3 on the left hand side, this will become minus. Now this is, solve this, 2n minus 2 equals, when we multiply 7 with n, this will become 7n minus 7. 7 plus into minus 1, that is minus 7. So this is 60 plus 60 minus 2 minus 2, and this minus 7 become plus 7 when it goes in the left hand side, and this 2n becomes negative when it goes in the right hand side. So this 7n minus 2n, that is 5n. Now this will be 60 minus 2, that is 60 plus minus minus, and the symbol will be of the greatest number. Here the greatest number is 60. So 60 plus 7, this will be 67. Sorry, this is 60 minus 2, that is 58, and plus 7, that is 65. This is 5n. So n will be 65 divided by 5, that is 13. So the 13th term of both the APs will be equal. You are also you can also be asked to find the term that is equal in both the APs. So find 13th term from any of the AP. Find 15th term from any of the AP. If it asks, find the equal term for the APs. Next question is, determine the AP whose third term is 16 and seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. Now, let, because we have not given any term, so let the first term of AP equals A, and let the common difference, that is D, let common difference D. Now according to statement, third term is 16, so third term A3 will be A plus N minus 1 into D. So this will be A plus 2D, that is given 16. And the next statement is given that seventh term, that is A7, exceeds the fifth term by 12. So this is according to the statement. And now substitute, A7 is A plus 7 minus 1, that is 6D, equals A plus, this will become 4D plus 12. Now solve this. This will get cancelled out, and 6D minus 4D, 6D, this is plus 4D and become minus 4D when it goes in the left hand side, equals 12. And from here, this is 2D equals 12, because plus minus minus, and the symbol will be of greatest number. Now D will be 6. We have find D, that is 6. Now substitute this D in the equation, this. So A plus 2 into D, that is 6, equals 12. So A plus 2 into 6, 12, equals 16. So A will be 16 minus 12, that is 4. We have find A and D, and we have to find the AP. So first term is 4, and add D, we will get the AP. To get the AP, first term is 4, add, for second term this will be A plus D, that is 4 plus 6, 10. For third term this will be A2 plus D, that is 16. So 4, 10, 16, 22 will be the AP. Now find the 20th term from the last term of the AP. Student, we have two methods to doing this sum, but we go for, dekho, first we have given the AP, that is 3, 8, 13, 253, but we have to find the 20th term from the last. So first of all, the AP is 3, 8, 13 and 253. Find last second term by finding the D. Here the common difference D will be 8 minus 3, that is 5. So the last second term will be 253 minus 5, that is 248. This will be the last second term. Now reverse the AP. Now reverse the AP. So the AP will be 253, 248, and so on, that is 1383. Now you will you can find the 20th term from the starting, because we have reversed the AP. You can easily find here D will not be 5, D will be 248 minus 253. That is minus 5. D will be minus 5, A will be 253, and you will you can find A20, that is A plus N minus 1 into D. The next question is, we have given that the sum of 4th and 8th terms of an AP means A4 plus A8. 4th and 8th term ka jo sum hai wo kitna hai? 24. And the sum of A6 and A10, that is 6th term and 10th term, is 44. Find the first 3 terms of AP. To find first 3 terms of AP, we have to find A and D. By using these two equations, we can easily solve two variables, that is A and D. Because A4 is A plus 3D and A8 will be A plus 7D, and you will solve this and find the value of A and D, then you can easily write down the AP. The last question is, Subba Rao started work in 1995 and an annual salary of 5000. एक पर्सन है नेम्ड है सुब्बा राव, वो वर्क स्टार्ट करता है 1995 में, और उसकी जो स्टार्टिंग सैलरी होती है 1950 में जो उसकी सैलरी है दैट इज 5000 एंड रिसीव्ड एन इंक्रीमेंट ऑफ रुपीज 200 ईच ईयर, मींस 1996 में जो उसका इंक्रीमेंट लग के जो सैलरी बन जाएगी वो कितनी हो जाएगी 5200 5200। सिमिलरली 1997 दिस विल बी 5400। Now you can see that this is AP, and you have to find that in which year did his income reach 7000. Means this is nth term and A is 5000, this is A and D will be 200. You can find N and then add this in and find the year in which his income will be 7000. Okay student, here we have only last question, that is 20th, and this is similar to the 19th question. So try yourself, and we have completed the exercise 5.2. So try this and ask your doubts. Okay student, thank you and have a nice day.